episode 2908, The Power of Change and Renewal.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy, happy day. I hope the kickoff to your first week of the new year has been a splendid one. Yes, happy, happy new year. Can you believe it? We have arrived, 2023. Who's counting anyway? I don't know. I lost count about maybe two or three decades ago. But today is all about leadership, your mindset, where God wants you to go. It's the power of change and renewal. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and to sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. As a quick announcement, I want to let you know you are the first. Yes, pray.com. We are partnering with them. We are so thrilled and excited. New things are coming this month. Yes, stay tuned because in a few days you're going to hear some exciting news. All I can say is listen up, TV show. Okay, that's all I'm going to give you, that little hint. Hopefully you heard me, or just, you know, press that 15-second rewind and you can play it again and turn the volume up. But what I want you to really focus on over this next quarter is where God wants you to go. This is a brand new season, and I believe that 2023 is going to be profound for many people. God has provision over your life. He has declared plans for you, but now it's up to you to accept those plans. Are you ready to do what God has in store for you? Because I get it, change is never easy. But with any new season, you can choose to execute intentional plans to create your now. It all comes from the power of change and renewal. Now you also have to know, in order to speed up, you gotta slow down. But if your holidays have gone anything like mine, slowing down is the last thing that happened. In fact, I was up early, stayed up late, got up early, and I don't know how much sleep came in between those times. In fact, I think really time started to move faster. You know what I mean? Which of course we both know that's not really true. Yet that feeling is really real. Even though it's supposed to be a slower day, resetting yourself for a new year, it's challenging. You're faced with old roots, but what you may have forgotten, those old roots can bear new fruits. We had some extreme frigid weather down here in the South while we were on vacation, and upon returning home, I noticed we had a dozen or so bronzed shrubs. Yes, you heard me right. They're bronzed. They're not the color they're supposed to be. The small evergreens are no longer green. My azaleas, well, I'm not sure what they look like right now. Let's just say I left with pink flowers and I came back with, I don't know, like dirty leaves? Not sure. However, with great care and a systematic approach to fertilizing and pruning, they will come back stronger. And I know this because it happened a few years back. Why do you think God created plants to be pruned? That's what I want you to ponder for a moment. Just as plants are pruned, we too need to be pruned. John 15, verse 5 says this, I am the vine, you are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. Have you ever tried to do everything on your own strength? You ever tried to push through? Have you ever tried to fan a flame? Oh, wait, maybe fan a spark that you wished would be a flame? And it just doesn't get there. Sometimes we're ahead of God. Oh, and sometimes we're behind God. God wants us to be present with him. So don't be rushed to chop this and cut that. Be intentional by rebuilding your foundation. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Rebuild your foundation. And keep in mind, that rebuild may mean that you're starting from scratch in some corners of your life. Yet in other corners, you might be just not cleaning up a little. You know, you got to get those dust bunnies out of there. But remember the question, why do you think God created plants to be pruned? Well, I love what he says in John 15, verses 1 through 4. I am the true vine, and my Father is the gardener. He cuts off every branch in me that bears no fruit, while every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes so that it will be even more fruitful. You are already clean because of the word I have spoken to you. Remain in me, as I also remain in you. No branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine. Neither you can bear fruit unless you remain in me. Why try to do a lot of things on our own? Why do it? When we like that control, or we look at it from the perspective of we want to do it my way, remember WIIFM, what's in it for me? We need to be tuning in to the conversation WIIFG, what's in it for God? What does he want for us? Because when we remain close to him, we remain in him, we remain close to the vine, what happens? We can bear greater fruit. But if we try to go off on our own, do things on our own, what do you think happens? Yeah, we fail more than we succeed. And life isn't about success, okay? That's not what I'm equating it to. Life is about what God has in store for you. All the little steps that end up being your journey in life, your book, your story. So today, it's a new day, a new season with a new reason, new fruit from old roots. So what does it look like in real life to rebuild your foundation? Number one, remove what is dead or dying. This is where you let go of what is no longer serving you. God desires something specific for your life, your purpose. As you draw closer to him, you will not need some of the things that held you back from your heavenly purpose here on earth. So you got to get rid of them. Maybe it's an addiction. That addiction could be anything. It could be shopping. It could be alcohol. It could be drugs. It could be gambling. It could be just spending money. It could be gaming. There's so many things. It could even be football, by the way. Just thought I'd throw that in there because, you know, great football season right now. Have you watched some of the bowl games? Oh, yes, I'm trying to catch up because I didn't have access to a TV much on vacation. So now I'm watching the on-demand replays of the games. And boy, can I tell you, they have been some incredible ones. But even football, as great of a game that it is, it can become an addiction that gets in the way of what God has in store for you. Cooking can be an addiction. Even your family can be. It is trying to find that balance. And so when we're finding that, we have to look at removing the dead or the dying. What isn't working? And there are things that we have to let go of. And some of it is we can't maybe be best friends and best buddies with everybody that we think we should be. Maybe that season has come and gone and we need to let them go. That doesn't mean we're mean to them. We're still kind, but maybe we're not talking to them 4 hours every other day. We maybe pick up the phone and we talk to them 1 hour total in a month. You still keep in contact, but you're not living life with them full out because this is not the season of where God has you. Remove what is dead or dying. Number two, discard the disease or distractions. When you're committed to God's plans for you, then the old must go. You set your mind not to the patterns of this world, but on the purpose of renewing your mind God's way. This is when the cutting or pruning makes room for the new. And this may require you to, well, redo. Just do it God's way. It's about taking, right, that old stuff and saying, okay, maybe I've been trying to keep all of this stuff. Have you ever gone through some old boxes and it's like, oh, wow, this is so awesome in the moment that you're packing them. But 2 decades later, you go through them and you're like, why the heck did I keep this stuff? You just have 2,300 boxes in your attic. Maybe 230 need to go. Or maybe 2,000 need to go so you can keep only 300, right? We need to declutter because when it's all cluttered, we can't see clearly. It's very foggy. We were driving last night coming home and it was very interesting. We would hit these patches of fog and then all of a sudden deer would appear right on the side of the road. Now, we were caravanning. We had 2 vehicles and it's kind of crazy. We weren't like right on top of each other, But my oldest son was driving in front of us, and when he saw the herd of deer, he would put on his hazards to give warning to us, right? Now, if we were distracted by other things around us or allowed our vision with the fog to be cloudy and distracting us from what we needed to be focused on as blinking lights in front of us and exactly what was side to side, what do you think might have happened? We probably would have hit a cute deer. And we found a few on the side of the road that, well, did not make it. We get distracted. We have areas in our life that are diseased, and we need to let that go. We need to cut it out. Remove what is dead or dying. Discard the disease or distractions. Number three, focus on the next right step. One step at a time leads to miles of greatness. And these miles of greatness, it's yours. God's already spoken it over your life. But you can also get ahead of God. And that's a warning. Live life in step with God. His pace, His way. Take away what doesn't work for a season and trust in God's reason. This is your day, His way. I love that. When I get up in the morning, it's like, praise the Lord. Thank you for another day. And I remind myself, it's not about me. It's about what God has in store for me. It's about being mindful and being aware of who's around me. Now, does that mean I get it right all the time? No. Does that mean I'm a perfect wife? No. Does that mean I make no mistakes with my children? No. Does that mean I have no laundry, no dishes to do, and I don't have to worry about cooking at all for an entire year? No. You know that's all to be a lie, right? It's great in our dreams, but it's not our reality. We still have a lot of work to do. Every day is a new day with new mercies. And we have to give ourselves that, but at the same time, we have to focus on the right next step and being in step God's way, not our way. You don't want to look like a snarly tree with branches growing all over the place. Pruning helps to keep your focus. It will also keep what's vital and will strengthen your foundation as you create your now. God has extraordinary plans for you, my friend, but you have to get out of your own way and let God lead. Be in step with Him. One step at a time leads to miles of greatness. So my prayer for you this beautiful Monday, may your new year be filled with a time of pruning and rebuilding. Allow your focus to be in step with God's divine plan for you. Change will not crush you. Change will simply refine you, rebuild you, and renew you. Restoration starts in the heart. Go out, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed new year. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.